2006.
The green hills and spring flowers may be fooling you, but the real story is far from comforting. News Channel 3 senior reporter John Palminteri joins us live from Santa Barbara. And John, we've had just a little bit of rain, and that means some costly options ahead of us.
And you know, we are certainly on one of the green lawns in Santa Barbara that have come back to life. It was all brown, dead, and crunchy here a few months back, you might recall, but the light rain that we have here and elsewhere has sort of brought it back to life. Conservation certainly has helped with our water supplies, and Lake Atchouma has not fallen as much as maybe we thought it would by now. It's about the same level as it was 3 months ago, but unless we get a tremendous amount of rain in the next couple of months, this good luck is going to dry up.
I'd be surprised if you could find someone here in Santa Barbara who didn't know what was going on.
Water worries are far from over. Even though we've had some bursts of relief, and our main water source, Kachuma Lake, has been at 28% of its capacity for several weeks without dropping any more.
We've been pumping state water into the lake that we have bought outside the area and are importing, and that's been helping a little bit. And the community has just been responding significantly to their requests for reductions.
Seeing the drought-dry brown lawns become healthy again can give us a false sense of security.
Water officials remind us just because we got a little bit of rain and our lawns are green again, we shouldn't be lulled into thinking that we are out of the drought. We are still very low on water, and conservation needs to continue at the current level and in some areas even increase.
Seems like we've done well compared to LA, for example, and compared to some of the farming regions, which have they've shut down some of their farms to help, and we've shut down some, you know, landscaping.
You know, if you didn't know Santa Barbara and the area and everything, and you come here and you see all the green hills and the flowers are blooming and everything, I mean, nature could survive fine without us, but we can't survive.
And regional water users are trying a combination of sources to take the pressure off Kachuma Lake.
Goleta's gone pretty heavily to its groundwater. Carpinteria is going pretty heavily to its groundwater. And so we've reduced our take from Kachuma pretty significantly. We're still pulling water down from Gibraltar.
And in the next few weeks, Santa Barbara City is going to have a couple of very important hearings. One will talk about the water rate increase that is proposed for July 1st, and anyone who has some issues with that can protest or bring up their concerns to the City Council. There will also be a hearing to talk about the timeline for future water supplies, including the desalination plant, which, by the way, has an opening cost of $40 million. Reporting live in Santa Barbara this evening, John Palminteri, News Channel.